training areas. Here, you will learn how to begin moving forward. Take into consideration that the mouse aiming cursor is not a gun sight and only serves to help you turn the tank turret in the right direction. If you want to hit the enemy tank, wait for the turret to turn towards the opponent. Align the crosshair with the target. It will change color when it is over the opponent. And fire. Move the cursor over the indicated tank. Wait until the tank turret finishes rotating and the weapon sight to be aligned with the cursor. Switch to gunner view. You can use zoom to get a better... The aim assist indicator in the center of the screen shows where the shell will strike. It turns red if the current shell cannot pierce. Depending on your target's armor thickness, the aim assist indicator changes to various colors. One of the best ways to destroy a tank is to put its crew out of action. Move the reticule over the central area of the tank. Now, fire at the fighting compartment on the tank. When a shell penetrates armor, the X-ray window appears in the top right corner. The enemy tank is considered destroyed if it has no crew. Great! If there was any crew in this vehicle, they would be in big trouble. Now, switch to third-person view. Another effective way of destroying, or at least most armored vehicles have their engines at the rear. Continue by moving the reticule onto the rear of the indicated tank. Now, switch to gunner and fire at the tank end. If the engine, ammo rack, or fuel tanks inside the tank are damaged, this may cause an explosion. Good job! Move on to... Now, you have to complete a real combat. You can see a marker above the capture point. If the marker is white, this means that the point is currently neutral. Move to the capture zone. points than the other team, the enemy team begins to lose points. Victory is achieved when the enemy team loses all its points. So, always try to keep control. Great job!